that comes a little bit later. But I did come to Las Vegas and I wore my lucky shoes. These are my Kentucky Derby shoes. And so I'm hoping they'll help me in the casino tonight. But did you guys see, I think on the way in here, Hillary Clinton was having a press conference. Did you guys see this?
No.
And she said that the whole thing about the emails was just a big witch hunt. But you know, then the press conference was prematurely ended when a house fell on it. I'm crying, all right? I don't like this material. I just try to deliver it. About a year ago, somebody came up to me and they asked me about Brexit. And it was before it was in the news at all, and I wasn't even sure what it was. I said, what is it? And they said, well, England's thinking about leaving the EU. And they said, what do you think of that? And I said, well, I think they never should have joined in the first place. But the interesting thing about it is I think there is a dramatic movement going on worldwide where people are kind of tired of what they're getting from government. They're tired of the status quo. They're tired of the establishment. They may not be exactly certain what they want, but they don't want what they're getting from government. Now, some people say Brexit's about this, Brexit's about that. But there was one thing I thought was pretty cool that I saw the other day. It's called Brexit the Movie. And I saw a little 3-minute clip of it. And the 3-minute clip is about a guy they call the Regulated Man. And they show him sleeping in his bed, alarm clock goes off, and then they list in his everyday life, just for a couple of minutes, all the different regulations he faces from unelected bureaucrats in Brussels. So he wakes up, pillow, 109 regulations on his pillow, 19 regulations on his sheets, 32 regulations on his alarm clock, 134 regulations on his cell phone. You wonder, why would they want to leave all of that?